Oi, 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 oi. Coins. Hi, everybody. Today we're going to learn this whole week about the oi sound. Boy. We see this sign on the way to the cafeteria every day. It says boy on the outside of the bathroom, don't we? So today we're going to review some of the words that we've done in the past. And then we're going to learn some oi sounds. And we're going to learn the super kids are going to plant a garden today. It's pretty exciting. Just like Tinley was planting some flowers with her dad, the super kids are going to plant something too. So let's begin with some decoding. We're going to start with these words. I see a lot of or and a lot of er. That we've learned in the past. Are there any R? No R words. Here we go. Let's read together. Sport. Burr. Fork. Curl. Cord. Hurt. Short. Hurry. Storm. Church. What would I need to get if I was setting the table and helping my mom? What would I need to get? Ta-da! You are correct. It's a fork. We're moving on to spelling. Oh, wow. We have 6 words to spell today and 2 sentences. Yes. I'm loving this. I'm loving this. Let's listen to our first word.
Sport. Basketball is a fun sport. Sport.
Nothing but net. Sport. 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 S-P-O-R-T, sport.
Short. It can be hard to play basketball if you are short. Short.
That's not always true. My friend was really short, and she was really good at basketball. Short. Short. If you could spell sport, you can spell short. Short.
Storm. Golly was afraid during the loud storm. Storm.
Storm. Storm. Storm. All these words so far have or. S-T-O-R-M.
Fur. The rabbit has soft, fluffy fur. Fur.
Sandy has soft fur. Fur. Which er is it? It's not the most popular er. Which one is it? Fur. Now there is F-I-R, like a fir tree, but this is fur on an animal. And this is F-U-R, fur.
Curl. I like to curl up on the couch with my cat. Curl.
The blanket on. Yes. Curl. 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 C-U-R-L. I have to curl my hair every day. Curl.
Hurt. I hurt my knee when I fell down. Hurt.
Oh no, you need a boo-boo band-aid. Ha-ert. 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 And now I'm seeing a lot of U-R words. Hurt. On the card it showed Sal was hurt, didn't it?
We had to hurry.
We had to hurry. We had to hurry. Can you think about a time when you had to hurry? I remember one time my alarm clock didn't go off and I was late for school and I had to hurry. I had to run around and get ready really fast and get out the door. We had to hurry. I think the trickiest thing about this is going to be remembering that hurry is going to have two R's because you don't hear both R's. You just hear one. We had to hurry. Did you start with a capital letter? Did you end it with a period? Nice job if you did. We had to hurry.
The storm was coming.
The storm was coming. We know how to spell the storm. Storm, you can look back up here. Storm was, sounds like, looks like was. The storm was coming. And remember, we drop the E and we add mm-mm-mm. We drop the E and we add ing, the suffix. The storm was coming. You guys are turning out to be really amazing spellers. All right, let's read this together. Fire is very hot. It can burn, but some things are hotter. Can you name some? Woody sent me his paper, and I saw that he saw the things that were hotter on his paper. He put them in the right order. So good job, Woody. I like that. Very nice. And we found out the sun isn't the most hottest thing of all, is it? We found out a blue star was even hotter. All right, you're going to need your workbook today, and we're going to be on workbook page 86 and 87. And I'm going to need a pencil, and it looks like you're going to need one too. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to read these sentences over here, 1 through 8, and whoever it's describing, we're going to put that number next to that person over here. All right, so let me get my workbook. I can see it up close. All right. And let's see what it says. And if we don't know which one it is, we can always skip it and just go back to it in a little bit. A bee may annoy you when you work outside. All right, is there anyone here who is being annoyed by a bee? Is this a bee right there? It looks like it. So I guess we're going to be writing a 1 right here. All right. I'll listen while you read now. And this is the oi sound. Spoil. Ooh. She is digging in the soil. Who is digging in the soil? You see someone with a shovel. Do you see them? That's right. She's right here. So we've got to write a 2. In here. See her paint. Oh no, it's point. See her point at her plants. Do you see Etabetta? She's pointing. So we've got to put a 3 right here. Very nice. He has a small toy rake. Oswald has a small toy rake right here. So we're going to put a 4. All right, so you probably caught on to what's happening now. So why don't you put me on pause, and why don't you do the next 4 on your own, and then unpause, and then come back, and we'll check our answers to see how you did. Are you back already? That was fast. She has little foil packs of seeds. All right, who has packs of seeds? Is this Doc? It looks like she has them. That's number 5. Did you get that one? Good. He is coming to join the kids, number 6. Right here, I see him. He's running up. He's coming to join. Number six. Number seven, she keeps plants moist with a sprinkler. Ah, Tick has a sprinkler. My neighbor was wanting to run through the sprinkler today, but it was kind of cold for that. And the last one, the garden fills him with joy. Sal looks so happy. The plants are coming up and he's so excited. So we just did two pages. Lickety split, that was fast. All right, and now we're gonna go on to learn about what our spelling words are this week. And before we do, we get to see the new cards for the week. The oi sound, coins. Oi, 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 coins. A penny's worth one, a nickel's worth five, a dime is worth 10 and a quarter 25. Hey, honey bunny, I know my money. You guys know how to count your money. And boy. All the boys in the class are like, yay, it's our card. All right, we need to listen for 29 seconds.
Oi. 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 Soil. Toy. Oi. 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 This phoneme is a diphthong, meaning your mouth uses two positions as you say the one sound.
All right, so we're going to learn four diphthongs, and we're going to learn two of them this week, and then we're going to learn the other two next week. So a diphthong means that my mouth is going to be in two different positions. So oi, oi, oi. My mouth doesn't stay in the same place, like when I say a, or t, t, t. Oi. My mouth starts out small, and then it gets big. Oi, oi, oi. So two different positions of my mouth. All right, here's the spelling list for the week. We've got oil, boil, soil, coin, join, point, joint, joy, toy, and boy. So let's look over here. They're pointing to something. And if you cook a lot, you might know what this is. If you don't cook a lot, you're probably not going to know what it is. In fact, I need it whenever I make brownies or whenever I pop popcorn. And we're going to use the OI, oil. And that's something I haven't told you yet. When you hear OI at the end of a word, it's going to be OI, as in joy, toy, boy. But if you hear oi in the middle of a word, it's going to be oi. All right, she has a toy. A toy. That's a very cute teddy bear. Down here is a boy. And since the oi comes at the end, it's oi instead of oi. She is pointing to a bird. A oi, point. And we've got the card down here. Let's find the card. Make sure you can see it. Coins. Coins means it's more than one since it has an S. Coins. And right here, it looks like joy. He's laughing. He's so happy. So we have to decide which word we want to pick for these three words. I'm going to pick soil, just because we're going to be talking about gardens. And then down here, I'm going to pick coin because it's fun to count my coins in my piggy bank. And I'm going to pick point. And then down here, I want to pick toy. It's fun to play with the toys. All right, so you can pick the word that you would like to pick for the spelling list, but these are the spelling words for the week. All the spelling words will have oi, 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 oi. If you hear oi in the middle of a word, it's O-I. If you hear oi at the end of a word, it's O. How can I make a Y? Make a Y like this. Y like this. Y like this. All right, it's time to read the super short. We always read the super short on Monday. And I need to clear my screen out. All right, so our words, our story today is called The Garden Club. It's on page 138. And our words are join, moist, soil, spoil, pointed, boy, enjoy, and annoy. Ooh, spoiled food. I wonder if something's going to be spoiled. All right, so The Garden Club. This is our super short for the day. Let's see if this is our only page. Yes, it's only one page. This is it. Okay, let's take a look.
The Garden Club. Look, said Alf. He pointed to the note. Let's join the Garden Club. Oh boy, said Tuck. I'll enjoy that. First, we'll get seeds, said Alf. Then we'll plant them in the soil. Tuck said, a sprinkler will keep the soil moist. And we'll pick weeds, said Alf. Weeds annoy me. They spoil a garden. We have lots to do, said Tuck. Let's ask the super kids to help us.
That sounds fun. I've told you before that my husband has a green thumb. He's very good with plants, where I am not so good. Not so good at all with plants. All right, so the Garden Club, there's a sign down here. It says, join the Garden Club, get a free garden plot, you bring the seeds. So I guess they're going to give you a little area, maybe, of like dirt or something where you can plant your seeds. Oh, hi, Sandy. Are you wanting to plant a garden? Are you interested? My husband's trying to grow grass outside right now. And so Sandy's not allowed to walk on that part of the yard. And it's hard for her because she wants to. All right, we've got some new words to know. And one of the words is attract. And notice this bee is attracted to this flower. It wants to get the nectar out of the flower so it can make honey. Another word to know is guide. This woman is guiding the children. And she's pointing to something. She's showing them around. And our last word is flexible. A lot of you in PE showed me that you could touch your toes when I wasn't able to. Flexibility takes regularity, doesn't it? You have to stretch every day to get flexible. All right, so I need to tell you your assignment for today. Let me find your assignment. Okay, here's our assignment for the day. It's practice page 64. And what you're going to be doing is, oh, this looks fun because it's got golly. You know how much I like golly. You have four words over here. Boy, boy, join, join, oil, soil, and toy, toy. So you need to decide which word goes in the blank, and you're going to cut it out and put it with the correct picture. For instance, down here it says, golly, don't jump down blank. So which one? Oh, I see Golly jumping right here. So it looks like you'll be putting that one right there, and you'll have to decide which word goes in the blank. You'll have to test them out. Golly, don't jump. Down, boy. Sounds pretty good. Oh, and Golly's digging in the garden. That's not going to be good for the seeds. And Golly's got someone's stuffed animal here. And what is Golly doing here? Is he coming along? Yeah, it's one of these words. He needs to come along with the group. All right, so that's what you'll be doing on your practice page. So you'll be reading the super short, unless you've already read it with me. And then you'll be doing the practice page. All right, where did my practice page go? Oh, there it is, okay. All right, so I'm gonna stop sharing now so we can show our Go Noodle for the day. And I thought this one would be really fun. It's gonna get you up and moving and acting silly. Gonna be so silly today.
A moose-cha-cha. Thumbs up, thumbs up. Elbows back, elbows back. A moose-cha-cha. Thumbs up, thumbs up. Elbows back, elbows back. Feet apart, feet apart. Knees together, knees together. A moose-cha-cha. A moose-cha-cha. Thumbs up, thumbs up. Elbows back, elbows back. Feet apart, feet apart. Knees together, knees together. Chest out, chest out. Tail out, tail out. A moose-cha-cha. A moose-cha-cha. Thumbs up, thumbs up. Elbows back, elbows back. Feet apart, feet apart. And knees together, knees together. Chest out, chest out. Tail out, tail out. Elbows back, elbows back. Feet apart, feet apart. And knees together, knees together. Chest out, chest out. Tail out, tail out. Tongue down, tongue down. I fat.
A moose-cha-cha.
Oh, that was hilarious. Always question, always wonder. Oh, that sounds like our science. Yes. All right. I hope you have a great day. And let's see, what will we be doing today? In math, we'll be learning about cubes and cylinders. And in history, you're going to read about My America the Beautiful. And in your Easter book, you're going to learn about Jesus crucified on the cross. All right. I hope you have a great day. Bye-bye.